16 over Alabama, so tied at 1-7.
Welcome back to the Foster Auditorium. We are starting the third set. Can Alabama win the set and go on to set number 4? And the score is tied at 1-1. Man, this is going to be a serious heck of a game. I know. I remember a year ago, I went to a women's volleyball game. In fact,
she intentionally created a tool.
I went to two women's volleyball games last year. One, I know, was held at the Paris and Mechanical Hall, and then
harder than anybody's ever seen. You create a hole through the floor. A point is a point. A kill is a kill. So the storyline is: Allen took over the second set. After AG had really dominated the first set for Alabama, both of them now have 10 kills, really with flip-flop performances. Allen only having one or two kills in the first set and making up the other 8 or 9 in the second, and AG starting with 8 kills in the first set and only having 2 in this last one. So I'm anticipating, we're hoping to see one of them continue to dominate, maybe both of them turn back up, or maybe we'll see things balance out a little bit.
What do you think will be keys for both teams here as we get ready to begin the third set?
If I'm Coach Reed, I'm drilling into my blocker's hands. You know who's getting set. You know who's got the hot hand right now.
Okay, now right now, we need to get ourselves on the board because, you know what I mean.
And be disciplined with your hands. That can make all the difference. A fraction of a second, a fraction of a turn can make all the difference in whether you...
You know, this is a reminds me of a video game, which is like women's college volleyball,
You dominated,
like college volleyball video game.
We're
gonna have all these schools on here, but I'm hoping they can, you know,
keep being aggressive.
We have all these teams and
we'll
much more to come.
Set 3.
I wonder, can he do like a TV
Alabama
deal? Since they can't do it for EA College Football 25, but it's all right.
Volleyball is upon us. Do you have a favorite memory, season opener, or just the season starting in general?
That's a great question.
We are on SEC Network Plus for this today's opening matchup and opening game here in Tuscaloosa, Alabama.
And I tried to get my hands up as quick as I could, but the ball really honestly made contact with both my hands and my head.
In Tuscaloosa, Alabama.
And I had closed my eyes and I had no idea where the ball went. So you watch on film, I turn to see
now, the score is kind of 1-1, so we are going to set number 3, and we are underway. Here we go. Hoping we can make some points.
Underway at set 3. That was away with
come on. Get, oh my God. Come on. We got a little work to do out there, like we said before.
So heavy. All the second set. So smart to throw that tip right over the block.
We don't have anything.
Are on their heels.
Come on, let's go. Well, net is out.
So both teams have struggled in that area. Both teams have at least 8 serving errors today.
You know, there are different things that can affect that. The temperature of the gym can. If you go to a colder gym, it's easy for that ball to float further. So there's a chance that Foster's not usually this cold and the Alabama players aren't used to it. And Grambling usually practices in a little bit of a higher,
here we go,
higher temperature.
Pass to Allen. Why not?
What?
She's been sensational today. 12 kills.
Huge, huge swing. She did a great job of getting that ball to go sharp.
So again, we're live at...
And that Alabama defense, they have to get
it is 3:35 p.m. in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, but over there in Tuscaloosa, Alabama, I don't know.
As Grambling's attacking it.
Paris Thompson is on the floor for the first time, the Notre Dame transfer. There she is. That was her first swing. There you go. Check in the game and immediately pick up a kill on your first swing as she's all smiles.
That's a great immediate impact. We talked to Coach Reed a little bit about that, about what she thinks these transfer.
And we have some cheerleaders here. We'll be supporting the team today.
Experience.
But I don't think the band would not give me to do that.
Tough serve, resulting in an ace for
that is very tough serve. There we go. There we go. There we go.
Loves to see as much as we've seen a lot of errors today,
for the women's volleyball.
Sure, she's trying to get her players to reel it in. She loves to see her players go back and win the point from the service line.
Resulting in a kill for Lauren Bourne.
Tie ball game at 3 apiece on this third set, though. But I know the score is tied at 1 apiece. And here she is.
Round with a serve, the Alabama A&M transfer. There's Thompson. She just continues to take advantage of her opportunities.
He really loves volleyball, especially he plays volleyball ever since then.
The Grantley block was actually set up in pretty good position, but that swing was just so hard and heavy, she was able to keep it on their side of the court.
How tough is that to do, to not play at all the first two sets, enter in set three and immediately make the most of your opportunities?
That is the challenge of being someone who doesn't start in... And the challenge of being a player on a team when you know you're an opening weekend and your coach is going to be trying out different lineups, playing with different things, you've got to stay ready. And the biggest way you do that is watch the player on the court who plays your position. Watch how she's succeeding. Watch where there's maybe room for improvement or a change needs to be made so that when she goes in, she's ready to do it.
The women's volleyball.
Key shot to Campbell. Tiger is ready for it that time. Thompson.
Oh my, oh my. That is way off. And the points goes to us. And welcome to the opening game here at the Foster Auditorium in Tuscaloosa, Alabama. You know, sometimes the women's volleyball games can sometimes can held at between Foster Auditorium and sometimes at at the Coleman Coliseum in Tuscaloosa, Alabama.
Penetrating far and deep into the other team's court.
But the marching band name is the Million Dollar Band. The Million Dollar Band is what we call them. And for Georgia, they call the Red Coat Band, because the Red Coat Marching Band, they're the best, definitely the best band in the land, the best one ever. And it goes to Alabama too, and they both have made some friends together.
She says it was touch. Will we have a challenge?
We have a challenge right now.
Alabama head coach, Coach Reed, does indeed want a challenge. That was like slow motion.
And I'll tell you something, because now this is what I'm saying. That Georgia...
To see if the Grambling blocker made contact with the ball up by the net.
The reason why I like real women's college volleyball games, because... It's so much fun to watch, just like I did 1 year ago when I was used to be in the marching band for the women's volleyball.
Does the spin on the ball change?
Yep, for the women's volleyball. I prefer to wear my...
From that angle, I think this is going to be a tough call to overturn.
We've already seen calls be overturned multiple times.
And you know... My first women's volleyball player that I have met 1 year ago was. Yeah, I was talking to. Yeah.
Chelsea Carter, and it looked like she was going to come back here.
You were awesome out there.
What's your name? Me, Kyle.
One of the members of the marching band.
Have that conviction. She'll go say, take another
Your
look.
Band has just been killing me.
Yep.
Again, we are getting a great look at this new replay system. The Hawkeye Smart Replay System is what it's called. It's also used by the NFL, Major League Baseball,
yep.
NHL.
So after the rehearsal,
English Premier League,
I hate to win this game all day.
Organizations. So here you see it right there.
It's crazy.
The first unsuccessful challenge of the match. Point will stay.
For the women's volleyball. The women's. Starting tomorrow, it's going to be a very busy, special day. Why? Because
Keyshock to Campbell. You can see Campbell immediately turns to Keyshock and is pointing up in the air again. These two.
Why? Because we have so much games going on and coming, and will be coming your way. I know it's going to be Georgia. We'll take on the Clemson Tigers. And then later on, it'll be Miami versus, I'm sorry, that will be Florida versus Miami game. Then, and then Texas A&M will host against, will host against,
Keyshock is still figuring out exactly where these players are.
Yes, it will host against, will host against, yeah, so Texas A&M will host against Notre Dame. And then Sunday, LSU will take on the USC Trojans. I've never seen SEC versus Big Ten. This is going to be kind of pretty challenged this year. Now we rolling. Now we rolling. Come on, ladies. Let's keep it up. Come on.
The block got out to her pin. That was a great job by Keyshock. I think a lot of people expected with the perfect pass and the opportunity she might go behind her to Daniel, who was running back for the slide approach. So jumping that ball to the outside pin was a smart move.
3-0 run for Alabama. What have you seen during this stretch here to take the lead?
Now, the only supporters we have for today's opening night, today's opening game of the season is the volleyball fans and the cheerleaders for today's matchup. The reason why I really love women's volleyball games because it's been so much entertaining. And again, about 1 year ago, I had went to multiple women's volleyball games. I know I went was against whatever team it is. And then I had went to another, which is against Penn State.
Allen pushed it over. There's Dunaway. I stick by Martin.
Whoa. I don't know what they're doing, but what the name
that
of the
right
shirt
there was a beautiful, beautiful dig, but that communication error that you kind of expect to have a few of during the opening weekend
well, camp was close.
Ended the point
camp
for Grambling.
Okay.
Williams got it over the block and down. So kind of a slow start for Williams, but she's really getting involved here in set three. She's up to four kills.
That was very smart of her. Her last swing had been a tough one through the block. So to go for the tip, I think was a really high IQ, high volleyball IQ move on her part.
This is Zeke serving out of Brazil. Is he in a college transfer?
Oh, no. Yeah, struggling start.
That was that tough float serve that we've been talking about. Zeke does a great job of getting that ball to cross the plane of the net, really nice and
low.
Always tougher to defend.
Keyshock to
Aichi.
What we saw right there, Graham, was a beautiful tandem where Daniel jumped in the air. Keyshock's running forward. I think the Grambling defense anticipated that Keyshock would look to find Daniel. Instead, she floated it just a little above her, and AG got to come up with no block in the air out of Grambling and swing on a pretty free net.
Well, Coach Reed told us the team chemistry, it's been outstanding with this group this season. And you see that chemistry with Keyshop and AG as Grambling picks up a much-needed point. Got the deficit to one.
That was another off-speed shot for a kill out of Grambling, which just speaks to how much a kill is a kill and a point is a point. It doesn't have to be your hardest hit to earn your team a point and ultimately a win.
You'll take one no matter what. Dunaway taps it across. Nobody really in the area for Grambling. 2-point lead for the Tide.
Such a smart move there by Dunaway. She's done a great job so far this match when she's been set out of system of coming inside and making a tough swing. So I think it was really great that that time she chose to switch it up and put that ball right behind the block.
Daniel with a serve, and that is out. 11 serving errors today on Alabama.
Last time she was in, she had had an ace, so I know that she had been given the green light to try to serve tough back there. It was always frustrating when you miss.
Key shot to Campbell. There's that duo again.
That is exactly the set that Campbell wanted. She was able to swing and make contact the ball. Look right there at the peak of her swing. That her hand is at the height of her body, at the peak of her jump. That's exactly where she wanted that set. Great job by Keyshock adjusting to her hitter's preferences.
25 assists now for Keyshock in her Alabama debut for the same for transfer. I'll pass over to Lucas. Lucas thought it was potentially touched at the nets. It was not. Alabama up 15-12 over Grambling. So this is Rapetti, UC San Diego transfer. Thompson, the Notre Dame transfer. What a third set for Thompson. 4 kills in this set alone.
Her swing went long, but Grambling was in the net. So point Bama.
Timeout called on the floor. Alabama up by 4.
All right, we'll be right back.